Good afternoon. The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Elaine Duncan, Chief Executive of the Scottish Bible Society.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. In a park in Cave, Bible Society staff were distributing humanitarian aid. A woman came and asked if they had any Bibles. My colleague was surprised to find that a whole queue had formed to receive Bibles. One man stood with a loaf of bread in one hand and a Bible in the other, and he said, "I know which is most important." It may be surprising that for some people, spiritual hunger can outweigh physical hunger during times of conflict and distress. Maybe another story from Ukraine helps put this in context. A few weeks ago, at the end of a service of Holy Communion for soldiers serving on one of the many front lines, Bibles were being distributed. A soldier came to my colleague Anatoly and asked for a Bible. He said, "I've never had an interest in God or religion. However, now I feel my conversation with God should begin." That soldier was searching for something that would give him hope and a sense of purpose in the midst of conflict, fear, injustice, and despair. The sociologist Emil Durkheim stressed that values enable individuals to feel that they're part of something bigger than themselves. Now, for that soldier, there were probably several layers of something bigger than himself: his family, the army, a nation rallying against a foe. And yet he was looking for something more, and he had a sense that the Bible would help connect him with God. In the Bible Society, we find that this is a common experience around the world, and not just in times of conflict and difficulty. People want the Bible. The values engraved on the ceremonial mace of this Parliament, wisdom, justice, compassion, and integrity, are all values readily found in the Bible and relate in some way to the character of God himself. So I believe that there's something timeless about these attributes. The accepted values of any culture, community, or individual can and do change from time to time. It could be said that the accepted values of our generation are individual achievement, personal happiness, and materialism. And of course, we could debate the truth of that view. However, I'm relieved that they are not the values inscribed on this mace. If they were, then we may find ourselves fulfilling Oscar Wilde's quip that we know the price of everything and the value of nothing. My prayer for you is that you will continue to act with wisdom, justice, compassion, and integrity, and that God will help you as you lead this nation. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Elaine.